Assalamu alaikum and welcome back once again. If you're a healthcare worker, you might already know how to use an automated external defibrillator. In this video, we'll explain how to use a manual defibrillator. There are two types of manual defibrillator, monophasic and biphasic. And if you're confused as to which one, take a look at the maximum energy level on the machine, and if it says 360 joules, it's a monophasic. And if it says 200 or 270 joules, it's biphasic. There are different types of pads like multifunction electrode pads, external pads, or internal pads. But in this video, we are going to demonstrate how to use external pads while delivering shock. To use pediatric pads, unlock and slide out the adult pad. You can also use this defibrillator as an AED by turning the knob to the side where it says AED. For rhythm analysis, you can either use the cardiac leads or the external paddles. If you're using the cardiac leads, place the red lead over the right shoulder, yellow over the left shoulder, and green below the apex. If you're using the external paddles, you have to select paddles from the rhythm monitoring settings and place the sternal paddle over the right side of the sternum and the other paddle over the apex. The manual defibrillator can be used for both defibrillation and cardioversion depending upon the scenario. Cardioversion is required for the patient who present with tachyarrhythmias and also who are hemodynamically unstable. Some of the tachyarrhythmias are atrial fibrillation, supraventricular tachycardia, or even ventricular tachycardia with pulse. These patients require preparation like sedation, shaving the chest hair, and an informed consent before going ahead with the procedure. The key difference between cardioversion and defibrillation is the use of synchronized shock compared to a non-synchronized one in defibrillation. When you use a synchronized shock, the paddles are going to analyze the rhythm and deliver the shock at the peak of R wave, which means you have to wait a couple of seconds before removing the paddles from the chest after pressing the shock button. The energy used in cardioversion is different for different cases. If it's a narrow complex regular rhythm, it's 50 joules. If it's a narrow complex irregular rhythm, it's 120 to 200 joules. And if it's a wide complex stable rhythm, like in case of ventricular tachycardia with pulse, it's 100 joules. Defibrillation, on the other hand, is used in cardiac arrest with a shockable rhythm. The shockable rhythms are two, namely ventricular fibrillation and pulseless ventricular tachycardia. The non-shockable rhythms are pulseless electrical activity and asystole. The energy used is 200 joules for biphasic defibrillator and 360 joules for monophasic defibrillator, or just use the maximum energy level available in your defibrillator. If it's a pediatric case, it's 2 joules per kilogram of the body weight. Now let's demonstrate the procedure. After you have selected the appropriate energy level according to the scenario, you need to lubricate the surface of the pad with gel to make proper contact with the skin. Next step is to charge the paddles by either pressing the charge button on the machine or the paddles. Now place one of the paddles over the right side of the sternum and the other over the apex according to the labeling. To ensure safety during defibrillation, always announce the shock warning and shout firmly before delivering each shock.
I'm clear. Everyone clear? Oxygen clear?
Check to make sure you are clear of contact with the patient, the stretcher, or other equipment, and also make a visual check to ensure that no one is touching the patient or stretcher. Also, be sure oxygen is removed from the patient. Deliver the shock by pressing both the buttons on the paddles and say, "Shock delivered."
Shock delivered.
Resume the CPR right after delivering the shock. I hope this video was useful in understanding how to use a defibrillator in your clinical practice. I would like to thank everyone who helped me with this video. And in case if you have any questions, do let me know in the comments below. Also, if you'd like to have any such procedures demonstrated, do comment them as well. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Ma'assalamu.